If you haven't noticed, I've been trying recently to get through the videos that I've been intended to make. Intending? Not intended. Through the videos I've been intending to make, I have a notepad with a bunch of one-time videos. Like these collection videos and collector's edition unboxings. So there will be quite a few of them in the next month or two. How about we get started? First, and like always, I'll be going in alphabetical order. I didn't count, but I might have about 15 Gamecube games. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Wow, exactly 15. Alright, well, let's get started. First of all, Dragon Ball Z Budokai. This is the first Budokai game. Of course, it's a fighting game. And I really enjoyed this. I spent a lot of time playing this as, I would say, a kid, but it's probably a teenager at that point. What year is that? Like 2005? Well, it came out in 2001. But I don't think I had it at that point. So it was probably like back in 2000 and... No, it wasn't. Anyways, I was probably in elementary school, so yeah, kid. But yeah, I spent a lot of time on this. Just playing the game. It was back before I knew what anime and manga was. However, I had read pretty much all the Dragon Ball manga. Because they had it in my library in French. So yeah. Enjoy this. I'm not very good at fighting games, but it's still enjoyable. There's, you know, I'm pretty sure there was an easy difficulty, so yeah. I also have the HD remake on the PlayStation 3. So, and I've gotten, you know, all the trophies for that game, so I have played this quite a bit, I would say. So, Dragon Ball Z. Okay. Next up, we have Final Fantasy Chronicles. From what I know, this is not a traditional Final Fantasy game. I say that because I haven't really played any traditional Final Fantasy game. I know. But, well, at some point, but not yet. This is... action RPG, maybe. I haven't played enough of it to know. I have played some of it, but I've never gotten too far in it. I'm not sure why. Maybe it was too difficult for me since I didn't understand English. I'm not sure. But I know that, you know, when I stopped playing, I just had no idea what I was supposed to do. So, my guess is that's the reason. But still, it was, if I remember correctly, it was kind of fun. Maybe I'll go back to this game at some point, maybe not. But it would definitely be easier now that I actually speak and understand English. I do like the graphics though, the art style, I mean. It's a nice art style. So, Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. Only for Nintendo GameCube. And as you can see probably from this, this is a game that was at a, what do you call them, like video game renting place, a local one. And when they closed, my mom bought me a few of the games there. So this is one of those. And the box doesn't close at the bottom. For whatever reason. Oh, never mind. I just got it closed. Problem solved. Next up, a game from one of my favorite series of all time, Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. I really enjoy this game. I really like Ike. I know he's really OP, but story of them. I don't remember exactly where the cutoff is in the story, but you know, I know that I enjoyed playing this, and it's a Fire Emblem with console graphics. What more can you ask? It's not modern, you know, there's no guns or anything like that, so I really enjoy that. The Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Next up, a game that I have because my mom bought it as a kid. I mean, all these games were bought by my mom, but like, some of them were bought for her. Mostly not for me, but of course they're still mine. That is Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. I honestly don't remember much from this game other than I know I've beaten it, because I've, you know, beaten pretty much all the games that I had as a kid, except Final Fantasy, Crystal Chronicles, like I said. But this is a game based on the second movie. I don't remember if it's good or bad or whatnot, but you know, it's a game. It says console action adventure game. I kind of remember having trouble with the Quidditch things and the duel, but that's about it. From 2002, wow, this is old. I forgot how old the Gamecube was. In 2002, I was 8 years old. Yeah, that actually makes sense. So that's Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, which costed $20 at EB Games Canada, 1999. I wonder if this was used. I think it was used because of how dirty it is. I mean, it's not too bad, but compared to games that I got new, this is pretty dirty. But, oh well. Next up, another game that my mom bought for herself. Choice. Again, for $19.99 at EB Games Canada. And used, I would assume, because this thing is really... Except if back then they put stickers like that, I don't know. I don't remember. But yeah, I can honestly say that I have not played this game. This was, however, like I said, bought for my mom, so... And I've never... As a kid, I was never into... sports related game, even if it was Mario. So, and I mean, I'm not, but I'd be more open to trying it. Like, I've played a bit of Mario Strikers at my friend's house, so, and it was fun, so, yeah. I wonder, do these have a full color manual or black and white? I'm trying to not be too loud in opening it. This is full color. I mean, maybe they weren't all full color, but yeah. Still have the bill here, apparently. It was bought in 2005. Or was that... No, 2008. I don't know. I'm pretty sure here it's... This is clearly the day. So this has to be the... month, day, watcher. And it doesn't really matter. And, well, this is clearly not new because there's stuff written in it. Oh, well. Again, it's not like I care much about this game, so I don't mind that it's not in great condition. So that was Mario Golf Toadstool Tour. Next up, Pokemon. on XD Gale of Darkness. This is a really original Pokemon title. You know, there's not a lot of wild battles, actually. There was only one place, I believe, that you can have them. It's about, I don't know, corrupted Pokemons. They're corrupted with darkness and whatever, and you have to get them all and, you know, clean them and stop whoever is trying to abuse of those. Shadow, yeah, the shadow version. Genesis games. I don't have many memories of this game. I remember playing one of these and hating it, but I cannot remember which one it was. I'm assuming it was 3D Blast, because, well, that's, I don't know. I think it was in 3D, so I assume it was this one. Because I remember there was no way to save, and that just put me off. I don't know. Maybe if I tried it nowadays, I would enjoy it more as a look back, but I don't know, I never played much of it because of that. So Sonic Mega Collection, great hits, 7 great hits. Next up, another fighting game, Soul Calibur 2. And this version of Soul Calibur 2, because it was on the GameCube, it had Link in it. I know that PlayStation had a different character, although I couldn't tell you what one. Transcending history and the world, a tale of souls and swords eternally retold. This game was pretty enjoyable. Like I said, I'm not the biggest fan of fighting games, and I'm pretty bad at them. So it's not exactly my cup of tea, but I do think that I at least beat the game. I'm pretty sure I did, at least. But yeah, again, I don't have much to say because I don't remember much of it. I just remember having a bit of fun with it, and that's about it. So, Soul Calibur 2. Next up, my third and last player's choice game, Super Mario Sunshine. I have to admit something here. just because, you know, I'm actually one of those who is not a fan of the 3D Mario games. I also didn't enjoy too much the Super Mario 64. Now, I'm not saying it was a bad game. I'm just saying that it wasn't my cup of tea. Like, I'm pretty sure I beat the Super Mario 64 one because, well, I didn't have any other games to play, so I didn't have a choice. But back in the Gamecube time, I did have a bit more games, and with school and all, you know, I didn't have as much time to play, so there are a few games that I didn't beat, and this is one of them. But, you know, I hear a lot of good things about this game, so maybe I will give it another try. Now that my tastes have matured a bit, but even then, I don't think I'm gonna, you know, get through it. I know I definitely could get through it, but, you know, I'd rather spend the little bit of time I have on gaming on games that I am excited about playing. You know, if I didn't have work or school, I mean, I don't go to school, but I did for a while, and then I will again at some point. But yeah, if I didn't have school or work, I would have time to play games that I'm interested in but not excited about. But right now, I don't really have time for that kind of thing, sadly. So, Super Mario Sunshine. Only three more games left. Next up, one of my favorite games of all time, and while definitely one of the games I've spent the most time on, you can probably guess what it is. Super Smash Bros. Melee. I want to say that this is to this day my favorite Smash game. I've enjoyed Smash 4 a lot, but maybe it's just because of, you know, situations, like my situation back in the day of the GameCube versus how I am now, my situations now, but I've definitely spent a lot more time on Melee. I've completed this game over and over and over, you know, deleting my data, just completing it again, deleting it, completing it again. I've just spent so much time on this game. I'm definitely good at the game, or was at least. I would not say that I've reached anywhere near pro level, but I was definitely good enough to beat all of my friends, whether they were bad, obviously, or good. But of course, I never played against pro players, so that doesn't really mean much, but yeah. My favorite character in this was Marth. That's actually how I learned about the Fire Emblem franchise. So there's also, you know, this also that. That's another reason why this game means a lot to me. First, because, you know, one of my favorite games, and two, it showed me one of my other favorite series of all time. So that's why it says bestseller, and that is for a reason. So the Super Smash Bros. Melee. Next up, actually, now I think they might be in the wrong order. I'm not sure. No, okay, they're in the right order if we forget the. But I think I'll put them in the other order, the way they're, you know, well, that way, one, we don't skip the. And two, they'll be in chronological order too, so I like the sound of that. Next up, The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker. A great Zelda game. I have also the HD remake on the Wii U, which I've beaten. And I'm pretty sure I've beaten the GameCube one too. Actually, no. I actually have not beaten the GameCube one, because I would always get bored when it was time to get the Triforce charts. you can see that the GameCube time is when I started to slowly lose interest in gaming, or, you know, have less time for it. I did lose interest in gaming for a while in high school, you know, because that was the not cool thing to do. But obviously now I'm over that. Well, first of all, gaming is a lot more mainstream than it was before, but I also don't really care what people think, so, you know, I'm not into that anymore. But back then, you know, that's how I was. So it was, you know, Xbox games, and that's all that really was okay to play. But yeah, still, now I can actually say that I enjoy this game a lot, and that it's a really good game. It was controversial at the time because of the art style, but I think it was a good decision. Wait, if you haven't played this Zelda game, I definitely suggest that at least that you try it. I would recommend the Wii U version more, because you know, it speeds up some of the more boring parts. Like, you can get a cell to go 2 times faster, I believe. So the exploring is a bit faster, and there's also less Triforce chart hunting to do. So yeah, The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker. And last but not least, The Legend of Zelda: Twilight Princess. I don't know why I said of. This is a darker Zelda title. However, I think it was very good. There's also a Wii version that has the map reversed, but from what I hear, the GameCube version is the superior version because it was developed for the GameCube. I have, of course, beaten this game. I don't actually remember a whole lot about it, but I do remember that I enjoyed it. You know, it's a Zelda game. I'm gonna enjoy almost every Zelda game. But yeah, this game, you know, you can transform into the wolf, and this is the game that Midna is from, as seen here. So yeah, that's The Legend of Zelda: Twilight Princess. So that was my GameCube collection. Is there any games that you have that you think I should try or have? You know, what's your favorite game on the GameCube? I'm definitely still willing to try some other GameCube games that I don't have. So, you know, if you have a suggestion, just let me know. So, that'll be it for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you next time. Bye!